Hey, Rainbow here, and welcome to my channel. Man, I'm going to take a little bit of heat for this one, but I think if you listen close enough and you hear the message, yeah, then maybe you might be a little more understanding. Anyway, I think this is a great discussion to have. It's the kind of discussion that's really never going to end. Now, it's about larger motorcycles and how practical they are, okay? Now, coming from me, you can call me a hypocrite, okay? But maybe I just don't make sense all the time. Let's continue. Okay, larger motorcycles, you know, typically those with engine sizes of 1,000 cc's and above, you know, we call them liter bikes. They are often considered to be the pinnacle of motorcycling by most motorcycle riders. They offer powerful engines, advanced technology, sleek designs, and that can be really appealing. However, when it comes to practicality and sense, which really motorcycles aren't, there are several reasons why these larger bikes may not make as much sense as the smaller motorcycles. First and foremost, larger motorcycles can be much more difficult to handle, especially for new or inexperienced riders. Their size and weight can make them unwieldy and very challenging to maneuver, especially in tight spaces or at lower speeds. This can make them less safe to ride and also increase the risk of accident or injuries. I mean, that's kind of common sense. Oh, and by the way, if I didn't ask you, please like, please subscribe. Do me a favor, just right there. Just go hit that like, see that thumbs up? Just click on that, please. And then that subscribe, yeah, you know what to do. Let's talk. Additionally, all right, larger motorcycles can be much more expensive to purchase, maintain, and insure. And we know how insurance is getting out of hand, especially if you are in the United States. They often require specialized parts and services, which can be costly, and the price of insurance can be significantly higher than for the smaller bikes. Another thing to consider is that these large motorcycles are not always the best option for city or urban riding. I mean, if you live in the city, you're already going to have a problem with finding a location to park it. But then when you have a lot of traffic, oh man, navigating through that busy, you know, streets and in that traffic, it's going to be a challenge. So smaller motorcycles, on the other hand, are often much more nimble and can be better suited for city riding. And I agree with that, because even myself, when I go ahead and I take out the KTM RC390, I have a tendency to get around traffic a little bit easier because it's a smaller bike than taking the big Ducati Multistrada V4 Pikes Peak out. Another important aspect to consider is fuel consumption, because larger motorcycle engines consume more fuel. All right, that means that more frequent stops for refueling and, most importantly, more money spent on gas. Lastly, in many countries, because I'm not just talking about the United States here, but in many countries, the laws and regulations for larger motorcycles may be stricter, and that can limit your riding options, which limits your freedom. Larger motorcycles, they may offer a thrilling riding experience, which is why we really get them, but they may not always make the most sense when it comes time for practicality, safety, cost, and ease of use. Smaller motorcycles can be a better option for many riders, especially for those that are new to motorcycling or who primarily ride in city and urban areas. So what are your thoughts on this? Comment below. Let's have this discussion. There are two trains of thought here. There's just the thrill of riding motorcycles, and then there really is the practicality for many people. So there are different aspects to take into consideration as far as I'm concerned. Anyway, this is Rainbow. Please like, please subscribe. Hey, thanks for being here. I appreciate it, and have yourself a great day. Bye-bye.